In this video, I will talk about how to memorize some basic formula of trigonometric and hyperbolic functions without actually referring to the formula table. Now, the first thing to do is to always draw out a hexagon, which is this hexagon. I will show you guys how to draw it. And you need to know a hexagon actually consists of six sides. After that, we must write out the formula, which is tangent, sine, cos. The basic formula is tangent, sine, and cos. And you need to know that the opposite of tangent is cotangent. So the opposite of tangent is here. So this is cotangent. And the opposite of sine is cosecant. The opposite of sine, cosecant. And the opposite of cos is secant. And one thing you need to know is that the middle here is always a 1. It's always a number 1. Now, here's the secret how you would obtain the formula based on this hexagon. Now we will talk about trigonometric function first. So for trigonometric, you must use the operation plus. And this is how it works. First, if you have sine square x, so the direction is like this. The first one, the second one, and this is the third one. For the first formula, sine square x plus 1, sine square x plus cos square x equals to 1, which you can get it from the first direction here. And second formula, tangent square x plus 1 equals to secant square x, which you can get it from this second direction. And the third formula is 1 plus cotangent square x equals to cosecant square x, which you can get it from the third direction here. So one thing you need to remember is that for trigonometric function, you must use the operation plus, which means this is plus and this is plus, this is plus. And that's it for the trigonometric function. When we get into hyperbolic functions, the first step, we do the same. For the first step, we do the same, which is write out all the formula: sine, cos, tangent, cot, secant, and cosecant. Because now we are dealing with hyperbolic functions, so we must add a hash indicating that this is a hyperbolic function. And it's the same. In the middle here, we have a 1. What's the difference is that instead of going with this direction, for hyperbolic function, we are actually going with this direction. So the first formula for hyperbolic is hyperbolic cos square x minus hyperbolic sine square x equals to 1. And for hyperbolic function, we always use a minus here, which is, you can see from here, we are having a minus sign. And the second formula, 1 minus hyperbolic tangent square x equals to hyperbolic secant square x. Hyperbolic secant square x. And the third one, we have hyperbolic cotangent square x minus 1 equals to hyperbolic cosecant x. hyperbolic cosecant x. And to summarize and make the knots neat, this is it. What you need to pay attention is the plus sign and the minus sign, and that's it for this video. In the next video, I will talk about how I memorize the derivatives of trigonometric functions using this hexagon method too. That's it. Thank you.